Crucified for us, have mercy upon us.
O Lord, our Redeemer, who has crucified for us, have mercy upon us.
O Lord, Holy Spirit, have mercy upon us.
O Lord, Holy Spirit, have mercy upon us.
O Lord, accept our prayers and praises and have mercy upon us.
O Lord, have compassion and mercy upon us.
Let's pray. Almighty God and everlasting God, in whom we live and move, in whom we begin and end, and having our being, grant to us purity of heart and strength of purpose, so that we may seek you well and do it without fathering and all, magnify your holy name, for the sake of Jesus Christ, your Son.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here in the presence of God to join Suraj and Susan in marriage. This is a way of life instituted by God, and the Holy Scripture commands all men and women to hold it in honor. Our Lord Jesus Christ has blessed it by His presence at Cana of Galilee. About this way of life, hear what our Lord says. From the beginning of the creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one. So they are no longer two, but one. What therefore God has joined together, let no man put asunder. Marriage is therefore not to be undertaken lightly or ill-advisedly, but seriously and prayerfully, duly considering the purposes for which it is ordained. It is ordained that husband and wife may give to each other life of companionship, help and comfort, both in prosperity and in adversity. That God may hallow and direct the natural instincts and affections created by Himself and redeemed in Christ. That children may be born and brought up in families in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ to the glory of God. That marriage being thus held in honor, human society may stand upon firm foundations. These two persons, Suraj Satish Jacob and Susan Abraham, have come here to be made one in this holy estate. But if anyone here knows, let's pray. Almighty and most merciful Father, without whose help we cannot do anything as we ought, we pray that as you have brought these persons together by your providence, you will enrich them with your grace, that they may enter into the marriage covenant as in your sight, and truly keep the vows they are about to make through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Suraj, will you take Susan to be your wife and cleave to her alone? Will you love her, honor her, and be a faithful husband to her as long as you both shall live? Susan, will you take Suraj to be your husband and cleave to him alone? Will you love him, honor him, and be faithful wife to him as long as you both shall live? Who gives Susan to be married to Suraj? I, Suraj, take you, Susan, to be my wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in health and sickness, to love, cherish and protect, as long as we both shall live, according to God's holy law, and to this I give you my pledge. I, Susan, take you, Suraj, to be my husband, to have and to hold for this day forward. Sorry, from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in health and sickness, to love, cherish and obey, as long as we both shall live, according to God's holy law, and to this I give you my pledge.
God has heard your voice and we are witnesses. Let's all bless this mantragodi and ring. Let's pray. Almighty God, bless these rings, Minu and mantragodi. O merciful Father, that those who give them and those who wear them may ever be faithful one to the other and continue together in love and grace so long as they both shall live, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. I, Suraj, wed you with this ring as the covenantal sign of our constant faith and abiding love. With my body, I honor you. What I am, I give to you. What I have, I share with you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I, Susan, wed you with this ring as the covenantal sign of our constant faith and abiding love. With my body, I honor you. What I am, I give to you. What I have, I share with you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. When the choir sings hymn 337, Adya Vivahanal Malayalam, Suraj will chai the mantrakodi, the tali, and then he'll cover her with the mantrakodi.
Oh,
While the choir sing O Perfect Love as a prayer song, let's all bow our head and pray for Suraj and Susan. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done in earth. Since this is an one-man show, I have to do this also. This is a time to give you a message pertaining to your marriage, not only for Suraj and Susan, those who are married and present here, and those who want to marry. At the outset, I would like to greet Susan and Suraj. You might think you expect Suraj should be the first. No, Susan and Suraj, as you came together in marriage, let me welcome you to this family. This is Sendamas family. Tholasheri, you're free to come and visit whenever you are free. And from this day onward, you are part of this church. And wherever you go, you come here, worship. When you get a child, bring here, baptize here. When you get a son, ask him to come to marry this church, come to this church and marry. Now you have to follow all these things. That was the reason I said that you are part of this family. You might have heard that marriage is honorable in all. Have you heard? Yes. As far as you are concerned, this is the most gracious and graceful day in your life. Because I do believe that this is your first marriage and the second marriage. Right. Yes. So we consider marriage as great because it is biblically ordained that you should not be alone. When you live, you should have a companion, not a male companion to Suraj, a female companion. Not a female companion to Susan, a female companion, male companion to Suraj. That's why, you know, the two families, Cholagatha family and Kuldaman family, they have decided to bring you together in marriage. And we are glad that you are here in this church to celebrate that great auspicious day. I was told by one friend that marriage is happy and suitable if two families decides, or if the two families decide to send their son and daughter in marriage. I hope that is true at your end. True. Yes. Good. When God had created the world, and we know the fact that the story behind the creation. We are created. Man was alone. God was not happy. So he took a rib and gave to your partner. For in everyone's case, actually the inquiry in marriage is in search of that fitting rib. That's true. So when Suraj was born, after a few years, no, Susan was also born in this world. And there is one rib that was lacking in you, was fixed in Susan.
we should believe in such a way. And we have been searching through M. Mary, Manorama Mary, all the Mary, you know, inquiries, you know, sentence, you know, we will inquire. And wherever you go, at last, we'll come together in the place where you were supposed to be. That's where, you know, the Cholagathu family and the Kudaman family have decided to come together to decide and to bring you as one family. So if that is the case, you will never break away, because there is a fitting context. What is the fitting context? The rip, you know, that you have, you have lost somewhere, is with Susan. That's the case. That's the spiritual reality behind every marriage. For Susan, till this day, marriage is a sacrament. But Suraj, marriage is not at all a sacrament. You know why? The Orthodox Church believe that marriage is a sacrament. But the Anglican tradition that we are brought in never believe that it's a sacrament. But when we take the meaning of the word sacrament, I also would like to join with Susan in saying that this is a sacrament. What is the meaning of the word sacrament? Sacrament is anything which has an everlasting value. Anything which has an everlasting value. So it has an everlasting value. So I may join with Susan, not with Suraj, in saying that it's a sacrament. So let your love, you know, grow day by day. Let your happiness, I was observing you when you, you know, where was that? Oh, no, I think, you know, perfect love. When you, you know, you were looking each other and singing, you know, sometime, you know, it was good. Anyway, sacrament means anything which has an everlasting value. Let your family relationship grow more deeper day by day. And I may say, this festivity will wind up today. What festivity? The marriage festivity. But relation and the contract and the covenant that you have signed today will continue, will sustain till eternal life. That's we are being together. To have such a relationship, you should have good love, faithful love. You might have heard this word, love stems from God. If your love does not stem from God, you cannot fulfill the covenant, the contract, and the things related to the marriage ceremony, and you cannot fulfill it, because no, if it is not start in love. As I've told you, love stems from God. So then the question comes, how do I know that Suraj loves Susan and Susan loves Suraj? See, he showed his innocence, he's saying that. He said, if I want to know that you, Suraj, loves Susan, this is my measure rod. If Suraj loves Mr. Bobby and his wife, that means Susan's husband, for mother and father, I may say, you love deeper and deeper, you love more Susan. The same way, if Susan love whom? Satish and Mini Andy, more and more, it does communicate the message that I love Suraj. What the point? So when I, as a person, stand from outside, if I look from another perspective, if I want to know that you are loving each other, how much you love the parents of Susan, that is the depth of your love towards Susan. So when I look from outside, I should know that you are loving very deep manner. It does not mean that, no, you should ask everything to Mr. Bobby. It doesn't mean that you should ask everything at the door of Mini Auntie and ask, what shall I do? It's not a matter. But respect, love, and care is very important. Another question, as I've told you, know, your relationship started here. I've told you, know, it should go till eternity. Have you heard the word divorce? Have you heard? Anytime? Never. Thank Lord.
So Bible says, if you are thinking about the word divorce, it's only because of the hardness of your heart. If your heart is hard, you will think about divorce. If your heart is soft, you will never think about the word divorce. So these are the primary things I would like to tell you, you know, connected with the Bible and the church relation and the society too. I would like to explain two words. You must have listened to the flesh. I said just minutes before said that you were two flesh. Now you are one flesh. Become one flesh. What does it mean? You will never be able to be one physical flesh wise, like Siamese. You cannot. You should not. One flesh convey the message that in every thinking you should be in on accord. In Malayalam we say aikyada. When husband goes to Tiruvalla, if she is not working at Kattod, is another place, you should not go that side. You both should go in that side. For that you should decide in advance that today we are going your selflessness. Submission means your service to each other, your accountability, and your respect. So submission means it does not convey the message that you should always obey what others say. But thinking in terms of flesh, you should be in on accord in everything. I will tell a small story with regard to selflessness and service. When Suraj and Susan was going to hospital, not this Suraj, another Suraj and Susan. And he was very weak, this Suraj. Doctor called Susan inside and said, Susan, your husband is in critical sight, isn't it? Very critical situation. He will die within 15 years. But if you love him carefully, sensibly, if you care him, if you give him good breakfast, lunch and dinner, in a very sensible manner, he will get another 45 years. Suraj and Susan, you know, they finished the entire checkup and entered into auto rickshaw. And Susan was very happy or gloomy, I don't know. The husband asked, what did doctor say? The doctor said, if you can care him well, he will live for 45 years. If you cannot, he will die within 15 years. Suraj asked Susan, what did doctor say? Susan replied, doctor said you will die within 15 years. I'm not talking about this Susan and Suraj. I'm talking about another thing. Selflessness and service is something need to be taken very careful, whatever, handled very carefully. So you're called and you are set apart as a family to love and to care each other. So let these two words, the flesh and the word submission, and let God allow you to realize the real meaning of it. Okay, right. You might have heard a person by name Rick Warren. I love him as he brought out a good book, The Purpose Driven Life. In his book, he starts with a quote, unless you assume a God, the very purpose of your life is meaningless. I would like to repeat that again. Unless you assume a God, the very purpose of life is meaningless. Let this be the motto of your life. You start with God, you go with God, and wind up your life with God. Then only when problems arise in your life situation, you will refer those issues back to God. So he is looking at me, what problem? You are very happy. See, you ask your father and mother, you ask your Susan, you know, your Bobian and other. See, wherever there is a family, it's a combination of two personalities. There will be clash. If there is no clash at all, I may call you as muff. What's the point? There will be clash all the time between Suraj and Susan. because you have two personalities. You may have two ideologies, two perspectives, two thinking processes and everything. But the question is whether you are able to settle it before the evening. Evening before you go to bed, you have settled it, everything. So you start the entire life, or you be with God throughout the days and nights and every time till your departure from this world. Church says four things to you. First, you should have personal prayer on a regular basis. The moment you get up from the bed, you need to thank Lord for making you or waking you up. So both of you know, you should have the personal prayer. The second thing, when you live in this world, you should have the family prayer. Family prayer means when you go to Banargatta Road, you, Susan, and call Bobby uncle and all. Let's have a family prayer situation. When you come over here, let Sadish and Mini call you all. Let's have a family prayer. So first, primarily, the personal prayer, then the family prayer. Sunday is set apart for worship. Then I would like to clarify, remind you something, Susan. For us, for the Anglicans, Sunday is set apart for worship. We are not supposed to have any other programs on that day. The wherever you are, you are supposed to be in the church. Anglican tradition will never allow its members to solemnize a marriage or baptize anyone on that day, because any program on that day will distort the sanctity of the Lord's Supper. Lord's Supper is the most greatest festival in the world. So Sunday is set apart for worship and Lord's Supper. So wherever you go, you make sure that you have your worship and go for another programs. That's why, there will be a clash between Susan and Suraj in that day. Decide that today onwards, Sabbath day is meant for worship, not for any other programs. So the third point, make sure that you be in a church and you are sharing your fellowship with God and your fellow people. And make sure that you are bowing before the altar and receive the Holy Communion. This is the third thing. The fourth thing, you are all well placed. You are all placed well financially and all. Everyone has a command to go to the world and preach the gospel. Unfortunately, you are not able to go to that area. But make sure that when you get a penny, make sure that you are sharing that share to the church or some other agencies where people are going to the remote areas of the world with the gospel. So these are the four things I would like to do. Shall I repeat that again? Personal prayer, family prayer, and the church service and Lord's Supper. And make sure that you share your tithe with the church or some other agencies who is in the field or sharing the word of God in the remotest area where darkness is prevailing. So these are the four things church wants to share with you. I do hope that you will take that in your heart. Word of God. One scholar said, word of God is like a gum. Chew it in your mouth and chew it like a gum and squeeze the richness and the beauty and the taste of that thing. So these biblical words and the experiences and the expressions and perspectives that I had made, let it in me in your mouth and chew it and squeeze out the richness, the beauty, the taste and everything of it in your day-to-day life. May the Almighty bless you, Suraj and Susan. May you have a blessed year, blessed family life. Enjoy yourself. We are glad that you are here with us. May the Almighty bless you by these words.
Oh, There shall be showers of blessing. This is the promise of God. There shall be seasons refreshing, sent from the Savior above. Showers of blessing, showers of blessing we need. Mercy drops on the sun falling, but for the showers we plead. There shall be showers of blessing, precious reviving on the hills and the valleys, south of abundance of rain. Showers of blessing, showers of blessing we need. Mercy drops on the sun falling, but for the showers we plead. There shall be showers of blessing, send them upon us, O Lord. Grant to us now a refreshing, come and thou order thy word. Showers of blessing, showers of blessing we need. Mercy drops on the sun falling, but for the showers we plead. There shall be showers of blessing, oh, that today we might fall. Now as you God we're confessing, Jesus we call. Showers of blessing, showers of blessing we need. Mercy drops on the sun falling, but for the showers we plead.
While remain standing, let me make few announcements. I thank everyone for being with us this morning. I thank the choir members for being with us. Even though they were all in various responsibilities, they made a point to be here and bless this occasion by their presence. I thank all the choir members, including Mr. P.C. Chaku and all the organists for being with us this morning and blessing us with your presence. I also would like to thank our church committee members for their extensive support. So also our sextons, they have done a wonderful job to make this service a solemn one. I also thank each and every person, those who are here, and bless this occasion with your presence. May the Almighty bless Suraj, Susan and everyone, and let God's presence be with us all the time. Reception of this marriage is arranged at our Hawksworth Hall. On behalf of the Cholagutta family and the Kuttidaman family, welcome you all to the Hawksworth family. May the Almighty bless everyone. Now the choir will let's pray. Heavenly God, once again we thank you for this beautiful time of marriage, for your presence and blessings. Lord, as Susan and Suraj go into the world in search of grace and mercy, help them and protect them. Help each and every one of us. Lord, be with us and strengthen us. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let's depart in peace.
We thank you for this beautiful time of great fellowship. We also thank you and pray for Surit and Susan as they celebrate their first day in marriage. Bless everyone. Lord, as we sit here, bless us with your presence and spirit, O Lord. Holy Father, we do realize that there are many in the world without food. Thank you for the food that is given to us. Help us to share with others and bless the food that is given to us, O Lord. In Lord's name we pray. Amen.